The Cure Bowl. UTSA against Troy. Troy currently a 2-point favorite, total of 55.5. This one's Friday, December 16th, 2 p.m. Central Time. This is an interesting game. Now, let's go on and pull this one up on your screen. I have got, now again, these numbers based on the last 6 weeks of the season, or since week 8. UTSA favored by 5.5 here. You start looking at these numbers. Now, obviously, I think the reason why Troy is favored as much as they are is because of that defense. But when you really break down the defense, yes, they're number 24 in PPA per drive on defense. UTSA's offense is number 8 in that same time span. Troy's offense, number 53 PPA per drive. UTSA's defense, number 67. So that UTSA defense is not great by any stretch of the imagination. You start breaking this down, UTSA likes to run the football. I mean, they run it well over 50% of the time, and they certainly throw it or run it more than they throw it. They are number 31 in PPA per rush. Well, Troy's defense is number 36. They are number 46 in rushing success rate. But here's where you start to figure this out. Troy's defense is number 75 in stuff rate. UTSA's offense is number 35 at preventing it. So that's a very interesting spot, because if you're going to give UTSA room, they have got athletes for days. Like, they will be able to create out of nothing. Standard downs PPA, standard down success. UTSA is number 7 in PPA, and they are number 14 in standard down success. Troy's defense is number 75 in standard down success rate. UTSA probably going to be able to stay ahead of the chains here. So just something to pay attention to on this. As far as Troy goes on offense, certainly running the ball has been their bread and butter. That is what they have been best at. Now, obviously, you go back and watch that Coastal Carolina game, and that's a whole different deal for the Sun Belt title. I think they averaged 18 yards per pass attempt. I mean, it was nuts. I think they had 12 completed passes for well over 300 yards. It was nuts. But this UTSA defense is not the Coastal Carolina defense. UTSA, not bad against the run. Number 15 in rushing success rate allowed. Now, obviously, a lot of this has to do with strength of schedule, but neither one of these teams has really played a tough schedule here. PPA per rush, UTSA is number 65, which means they're not good at rushing explosiveness. And that could open up some holes there. Troy is number 53 in rushing explosiveness on offense. You look at what UTSA does, they are number 128 in rushing explosiveness allowed. Definitely not good. However, it's so weird that they allow that, and yet their offensive line yards, UTSA is number 13 in offensive line yards allowed. They are number 60 in stuff rate. Well, Troy, number 26 in stuff rate allowed, but only number 47 in offensive line yards. Like, there's some things that they go back and forth. When I look at this, obviously you gotta toss in motivation. These are two very, very good teams. Number 21 in strength of record at ESPN is UTSA. Troy is number 22. This is certainly a tough game to cap, which is why, I mean, the spread's only 2 here. I think that UTSA should be favored. I think that UTSA will have the motivation factor. Obviously, Troy wants to win the game, but UTSA is 0-3 straight up in their last 3 bowl games, so they would like to get a bowl win for Jeff Traylor. I'm going to roll with it. So give me UTSA here. Now, I gave it out on the BetUS show. That is one of my best bets. I like UTSA quite a bit here.
Hey, if you like this video, go ahead and hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and of course, jump in the comments.
Thanks for listening to Winning Cures Everything. Make sure and subscribe on YouTube or your favorite podcast app, and make sure to leave a nice 5-star review. You can follow Gary on Twitter at GaryWCE, and the show is at Winning Cures. Be sure to check out the merch in our web store and share the show.